I'm in Chicago. What up, sweater reference? Oh, frick, did I wear the wrong sweater? Anyways, here's how it happened.
Just landed, and I feel like it's gonna be very cold when I exit these doors.
This is me.
Is it cold outside?
Yes, it is.
Okay, bye, I'm going back home. I can see my breath. There's snow on your car.
Welcome.
Oh my God. Look at this.
We made it. My nipples are daggers. I am actually here for NBA All-Star Weekend. You know I love NBA All-Star Weekend. I had the honor and privilege of going last year because I spoke on a panel with the NBA. I'm doing something fun with the NBA again. I am actually part of the first NBA roast, which I am both excited for and extremely nervous. More on that momentarily, but first, this room. Hello, hold on.
Blessed life, y'all. Okay, this looks like a spaceship. Blessed life, y'all, honestly.
I don't take these things for granted. I know if I was paying for this myself, I would never in 100 years pay for a room like this. I feel very grateful that my job lets me do things like this. Blessed, blessed, blessed. Do not take for granted. We are so privileged.
Miss Lolly Sange.
Let's just do a quick little. There we go.
There's this music playing in my washroom. I don't know where it's coming from. I'm just like, should I have a party? Oh, it stopped. Oh, there it is. Oh, my legs. This room is so high tech. I've never seen this before. On the front panel, there's an option to check the weather, like outside. L. Also, proof I'm not a bougie person, when you have these rooms sometimes, there's a button that says makeup room, and the first, like, I kid you not, three times I stayed in a room like this, I was like, where's the makeup room? What they mean is, would you like someone to make up your room? Like, clean it. I kid you not, first three times I ever stayed, I'm like, excuse me, hello? Yeah, my room is missing the makeup room. So, something monumental is about to happen. A few vlogs ago, like the beginning of January or mid-January, I made a vlog and I briefly mentioned that I am on a little bit of a diet. I don't know, can I speak English? English. I said I was on a little bit of a diet. I didn't give a lot of details about it, and I'm not gonna give a lot of details about it right now. I'll probably make a separate video about it. Long story short, I was on keto for 28 days. Today is the day I ended the 28 days. So for the first time in 28 days, I'm about to eat some carbs. Now, I'm kind of reluctant to do this because I wish I could still do keto. I'll get more into that, like I said, in the video I make. But yo, I haven't had fries in 28 days. I haven't had alcohol in 28 days. I haven't had none of this in 20 days. So food is like a sensitive, tricky subject. But for right now, without further explanation, my first fry in 28 days. I'm sorry, give me a moment. I'm sorry, excuse me. Oh, I'm not wearing a bra. Mac and cheese, pizza. I don't plan to eat like this every day, but for today, I'm treating myself.
Good morning, Chicago.
I've made my room a sauna. It is a good 80 degrees in here, Fahrenheit, but outside is minus 14 Celsius. Why I operate in Fahrenheit and Celsius? I don't know. My life is split in the middle.
You're headed to rehearsal.
All right, so essentially I'm here for the first annual NBA roast. And it's a huge honor during the NBA All-Star Weekend. And I am roasting the following three players. Are you ready for this? Shaq, Charles Barkley, and Kenny Smith. Other people on the roast on the dais are Tiffany Haddish, Lil Wayne, Dwayne Wade, Jeff Ross, Gary Payton, Jay Farrell. I am so hyped for this. I'm also very nervous because roasts are not something I generally do, but I think they're very important because I think it's a reminder that we should not take ourselves too seriously. So I'm excited. I'm excited to roast and be roast, and I will take it like a champ. Let's go to rehearsal.
Oh, would you look at this?
It's been a while, but solo elevator party. Solo elevator party. Oh my God, I'm mother effing shook. I walk in here and guess who's directing this thing? Look who it is! It's my
heaven,
Ryan! And it's
my heaven,
Katie!
I'm
so happy.
Yes.
Go Raptors.
As we go on, we remember.
Check this out. Shaquille O'Neal, you look different.
Yeah, I had a facelift.
You look different, Shaq. back from rehearsal. I always keep my privacy on because I keep my room a sauna, and I know when people come clean my room, they be doing whack things like turning on the AC, turn off the heat. Nah! So there was some drama. Basically, I'm here alone because instead of a team member, I opted to bring Humble to the All-Star game. Obviously, he's a huge basketball fan as well, so obviously I gotta get my boy. He's coming from Toronto, and he was supposed to land at 12:30. He messaged me basically saying they put him into secondary check for no reason whatsoever, and he missed his flight. So now he's on standby for a 3:15 flight, which would still land in time for tonight's roast, but if he doesn't get on that flight, there's a chance he'll miss the roast and he will not be here, and I will go up in there alone. That's gonna make me 100 times more nervous to not have Humble here, so I felt like this was my opportunity to make this vlog very dramatic, so here we go. That was a great shot on my end, damn. Real talk though, I really hope he does make it. That would really suck if he misses this. We'll see what happens. Rehearsal went great. I was a little bit nervous. I was trying to be really confident, and I think I did well, but I did flub a few jokes, so I do want to practice. It's just like out of my wheelhouse and something I haven't really done, so I want to practice a little bit and nail it, son. But I was telling people there, I was like, I think I'm the only woman on the dais being like, I learned this new word today, the roasters. Tiffany Haddish is the host master, so she's not necessarily one of the roasters. As soon as I found out I was the only female, I'm like, that's really, really scary and intimidating. I have to do it. I got seven. I just got so turned on. Look at this. Are you mother effing All right, we got an update, and it is not good. Humble did not get on the 3:15 flight. Here's the thing, it is a perfect storm because everyone is flying to Chicago right now. I feel so annoyed for him because he's literally just sitting in the airport waiting. On top of that, he's telling me how he's dealing with an unnecessarily rude flight attendant. I know where he's at right now. I've been there so many times. Excuse me. I feel so bad for him, but also like I'm very stressed that he's not gonna be, he's probably gonna miss my roast. If he gets on the next flight, he would land at 7:30. The event starts at 9. So he'd have to land, drive. No, let's manifest. He's gonna get on, he's gonna make it to be great, but. Time is 5:30, my hair and makeup is about to head up. We're about to get into this thing, and Humble is officially not making this flight either. So I'm riding solo. I'm gonna figure it the F out and F me. All right, what you think? The glow up, is it real? Is it real? Is it real? You know I had to come correct with the kicks. Here we go. No Humble, no assistant, riding solo. This is outside of my comfort zone in a whole new way. Let's go.
Your next roaster is a well-known YouTuber. So you can thank all your dumbass kids for her being here. Give it up for this lucky Lily Singh.
Yo, I have so much to tell you. The goddamn universe aligned. I get to the venue. I'm so goddamn nervous. The show gets delayed. Long story short, Lil Wayne delayed the show and then also did not do the show. Whatevs. No details. Because of that, Humble arrived right in time
Thank you, Lil Wayne. That's not the whole thing.
Yeah. Usually when I hit the stage, my stage fright goes away, but I was just so nervous. I was so intimidated. Everyone was so tall. Everyone knew each other. I felt like the new kid that was like the loner. I'm genuinely surprised he's saying that, and I don't know if he's just being nice.
No, I was behind all the audience members and they were all laughing. She legit killed it.
My parents are immigrants from India and they wanted me to pass this message to Shaq. Learn to speak English or go back to where you came from.
I'm very happy. I was super goddamn nervous. So it was really out of my wheelhouse. It's not my first nature to make fun of people except Humble and my friends. So it was very like new and weird, but it was cool. And I gotta say, people that made fun of me also nailed it. Like there's some jokes about me that I almost cried of tears of laughter because they're so good.
I always thought you were black. I mean, I think you should claim black more too. Think about this now. That way you can open a 7-Eleven and kick yourself out, see? Kick yourself out your own damn store.
I can't wait for you to see it. Now we're gonna order all the goddamn food. This mother effer right here just went on the journey. You could make a movie about this. You know the dog's journey? It could be Humble's
journey.
This
could be, yes.
It could be a goddamn 4-hour
movie. I have been
at
the airport since 10 a.m. They did not let me sit on a plane until 8:30 p.m. And in between, there were many adventures. I haven't even told her all the adventures.
Oh my god, and now we're gonna gup shop right now.
We are.
Real one. I did something cute today because I was so nervous today. I was really nervous for the roast. It's not something I'm comfortable doing. I was stepping out of my comfort zone. So I was like, you're gonna wear something that reminds you to step out of your comfort zone. So I wore this ring. Let me show you this ring. If you'll notice, this ring is a bug.
I hate bugs, but I wore it
as a reminder of like, do things. Wow, my eyelashes right now look like a bug on my face. Ah, I hate it. Take. Ah! As a reminder to be like, embrace what you're scared of and go for it. And also, yes, I travel and I have a pillowcase of bum and I put it on my pillow so I feel close to him. Judge me! Good morning! I am so tired. We went to bed so late. Me and Humble literally just stayed up for 4 hours, not watching a movie, not doing anything, just talking and catching up, and it was great. Now, in case you're like watching these vlogs and following my life and you're like, Lily always says she's cheap and she's all that, but she's living the high life and she's doing all that, I'm just going to explain to you how you could take the girl out of Scarborough, but you can't take Scarborough out of the girl. As I poured this leftover Cosmo from yesterday that I did not finish, that was definitely probably $24, into this water bottle so I can drink it later today so it doesn't go to waste. Why am I packing it and not just leaving it in my room? Because I'm switching hotels. Why? Because the NBA roast only covered this very bougie, nice hotel for 2 nights. So me and Humble are sharing one bedroom in a cheaper hotel somewhere else for the next 2 days. Cheers. Oh, I'm missing. Oh, it's all missing. Okay. You know what? It's still good. 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 Cheers. In our new hotel. This is more our speed. This is more our speed. Let me do the grand tour.
Closet. Bedroom. Hey, and you know what? They still have a fridge, of which we, of course, took Cokes from the stadium yesterday in my green room and brought them here. Aren't you so happy, we're friends?
Yes.
Aren't you so happy? What more do you need? Downstairs is a convenience store with chips. Like,
I bet you the chips are $3 as opposed to the 10 they were at the previous hotel.
Very impressed by the intro of the show.
On point. Soulful.
So because I was on keto for 20 days, I just started drinking. I'm a lightweight and I get drunk off of it.
We had 3 Raptors in the All-Star. They're probably more than every other team, so we really won.
Who are you including right now?
Siakam, Nurse, Lowry.
Including Nurse. Okay, that's fine. It was
a good
game, though.
Good morning, it is Sunday here. Yesterday was the dunk contest, one of the best dunk contests I feel ever. It was so good, so that was super cool. Humble's gone out with his friend, I opted to stay in. I'm feeling a little homesick, which is very strange for me because I'm so used to traveling, but admittedly over the past year I haven't traveled as much. So now I'm just feeling a little like being in the hotel, a little cramped. I miss Scarborough a lot. I miss like, I think I've been eating a certain way and now I'm like really not able to control what I eat here. So I think that I'm just like feeling a little homesick. Also got my period. That could be it. I know I'm feeding into the stereotype of, are you on your period? But yes, I am factually on my period and my stomach hurts. So I'm popped to Advil's, have some breakfast, do some work. I think I'm also just missing like my workspace. Other life updates though. I realize that I don't daily vlog, so you might not know a lot of things. I bought a new house. I saw about 8 of them. I knew I was gonna move this year, but I wanted to do it at the top half of the year just because I wanted to feel set for the rest of the year. I admittedly, just to be honest, transparent, don't know how much of that process I'm gonna vlog. Just for like safety and privacy and all that stuff, but I'm excited to show you the inside and the parts that, you know, are relevant to my vlog. But I'm really excited because I feel like this home is gonna be like, why I keep saying like, is good, is gonna be a longer term solution because I really do feel like I'm growing out of my current house with all of my house guests that never leave. Chicago, it's been great. You cold as hell. I'm going back to LA. Bye.